Dear colleagues, those are two cases of very, what I call very successful, and very quick and easy and nice surgeries. If you will try to do a perfect surgery, you might end up failing a lot. But if you try to be better than yourself yesterday, think in very short time you can do very excellent surgeries. I call an excellent surgery the one that you use the less amount of ultrasound, less amount of incisions, and less amount of instruments into the eye. Going in back and forth with the instruments will damage the cornea, regardless of how nice you construct the incision and regardless how nice you move your instruments. So, having here the phaco probe aspirating the cortical remnants inside the bag instead of going out and going in with different instruments, aspiration needle or irrigation aspiration port, single port, or whatever you might choose, I think you can do a very fine job using the phaco probe also if you try to perfect your surgery and if you don't rush in these moments. Injecting the IOL under irrigation will save a lot of cleaning up the anterior chamber from the remnants of viscoelastic. And using at the end of the surgery, pilocarpine or any agent that you can construct the pupil will have the complication of iris enclavated into the ports reduced to the minimum. So you have here the second case again. Aspirating the thick epinucleus and cortical remnants with just the phaco probe. You have just two incisions here. The recovery time of the cornea and incisions are very, very short. The potential of complication due to bad hygiene or any agent that may come out from the outside, from the lids or whatever, the environment will be lower and will be very reduced. And you gotta be very careful with the foot pebble, and that's all. But if you have patience to this time, you can do it as easier as you do the aspiration through the IA probes. Cleaning up the cortical remnants. Thank you very much, and I hope you.